Hey everyone, welcome to Blackhawk. I'm Jimmy and we are so glad you're joining us today. We're heading into Advent season and last week Matt shared about our plans for Christmas this year. If you missed it, you can check out the video on our website. Now, here are a few more Christmas related things happening around Blackhawk. Women, you're invited to an online gathering to celebrate the Christmas season. You'll share in the festivities of the season through music, a short message, and small group connection. Register on our website by Wednesday and we'll send you a special gift you can use during the celebration. If you've been watching along with Blackhawk Kids, you're invited to pick up a gift from our Be Kids family to yours. This free box is filled with items to help your family engage with our upcoming series, Christmas Unwrapped, as well as our special Christmas video. Our hope is that these boxes help your family anticipate and celebrate the true gift of Christmas, Jesus. Reserve your box by Wednesday on our website, and boxes are available while supplies last. Thanks again for being here with us today. If you're new, you can visit our website to connect with us and get more information. Now, let's worship together.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Susan, Director of Impact Ministry. For the past 12 years around the Christmas season, we've done something called the Advent Conspiracy Offering, where we take a step away from the consumerism of Christmas and towards the ultimate gift, Jesus. God's extravagant generosity in giving us the gift of Jesus compels us to be generous and to give an offering that goes towards things Jesus would care about. Through generosity, we can remind our communities that we, the church, are on their side and that they are loved by God. While 2020 has been difficult for all of us, and it's been truly life-altering for many, this year, as lives have been upended in our communities, our partners for this year's Advent Conspiracy have continued to help. I'd like for you to hear directly from them.
We plan to help our youth come into the church and teach them about technology. We plan to help our seniors who have been disconnected due to COVID and unable to go into social gatherings, but we want to give them equipment to help them with that. And we also plan to help those who have been furloughed and pay reductions on their job to help them with some expenses that they may cannot afford at this time.
During the COVID-19 pandemic and this time of social distancing, we know that not everyone is safer at home. And the services that we provide are essential. This support will help us ensure that we have the staff available to meet those increasing needs and families who are struggling with domestic violence during a pandemic.
This year at Advent Conspiracy, we plan on launching an internship program to place 10 to 12 high school students in internships throughout STEM companies in Dane County.
We're really working to help Black students who are struggling during COVID and during the pandemic because they're not able to be in classrooms, the parents are working, they're really struggling to stay on task. So we have found a space where students can come together and be socially distanced, but with volunteers and staff, we help them to stay on track for their academic goals, which is so important
This year, with the help of Advent Conspiracy, we're going to be able to expand access to and bridge the digital divide for kids who are impacted by parental incarceration, who are in our Mentoring Connections program, as well as expanding our Just Bakery vocational training program, helping us provide bread to food pantries in the community while expanding our ability to train students on high-tech equipment.
This program will actually provide food to the most vulnerable populations here in our community. That includes kids and seniors and families right here in southwestern Wisconsin.
And what we are doing with Advent Conspiracy is we are trying to serve our students who 90% of our population is at or below the poverty line. So we're trying to serve them by providing a computer that they can use at home. Most of our students don't have technology at home. And with virtual learning, we need computers.
Thousands of lives are going to be impacted with sanitation solutions to combat the COVID-19 pandemic, specifically in Tanzania. We're excited to see what God's going to do.
As you can imagine, the projects they mentioned are game changers for their organizations. And even more so, they are life changers for the people they serve. So many things are different in 2020, but our opportunity to be generous and to make a difference has never been greater. No matter what age you are, you can join in and we can do this together. Ultimately, it's not about a dollar amount. Our aim in this is actually not to reach a specific financial goal. What if, rather than thinking of a dollar amount, each of us participated as a church community just for the joy of practicing generosity and seeing what God can do with that to impact families right here in Madison and beyond? We are asking all of you who can to give. And then we'll give it all away. You can give to the Advent Conspiracy offering anytime from now through the end of the year online, or you can send a check to Black Hawk Brader Way with Advent in the memo line. To learn more about Advent Conspiracy, hear from each of our partners, and get involved, go to the website. In this season, we get to come together and come alongside these organizations and multiply their efforts. Let's show our communities that we are on their side and that they are loved by God.
弟兄姐妹平安，我是余明义，我是 Blackout 教会的神学牧师，也是 Blackout 教会的多文化事工牧师，欢迎大家参加 Blackout 教会的中文崇拜。那这个星期四就是我们美国的感恩节，我不知道大家对感恩节有什么记忆或者有什么习俗。我记得我们那时候刚来美国，在台湾从来没有听说过什么感恩节这一说哈。那在美国第一次来，我们家里也没有什么任何的习俗，因此我记得我们刚开始的那几年呢，感恩节都是在教会过的。我好记得那时候我们一下午就去了，然后小孩子像我10多岁就在那边玩，跟大家小孩子一起玩，然后呢怎么样呢？大吃大喝，因为每一家都带他们拿手的那个牌的那个菜，最好的又有各种，又有好多火鸡，有各种什么排骨，各种各样的都有，就吃的好，喝的好。然后呢，下面就听弟兄姐妹上台做见证，说：“嘿，今年我们怎么样向神感谢？今年神怎么样祝福我们的家庭？这是我们我从小长大的时候在教会里头的怎么样过感恩节的过法。那开始，然后我们开始上大学以后呢，我们感恩节就不这样过了，因为大家说：嘿，我们感恩节是能够全家团聚的这个机会，因此呢，便是嘿，我们是回爸爸妈妈家，或者今天去大哥的家，或者去大姐的家，我们就是感恩节变成是一个坐飞机飞来飞去的这个节日。我不知道你们今年有没有什么这些感恩节的计划，有没有想跟家人能够团聚的计划？我们今年什么也没有。我妈妈和我大哥他们在台北，我姐姐在西雅图。上次我妈妈说，嘿，能不能来台湾来看我们，全家能够团聚一下，可能是感恩节，或者圣诞节，或者是新年，对不对？说实在，她是80年大寿，我们能不能去看她？我们说没办法，我们现在如果去台湾，飞去台湾，一去台湾他们就把我们 quarantine 14天， 两个星期，之后我们马上就飞回来了，没办法，没有办法，你也来，你也没办法来，对不对？我们也不太敢他们让娃娃能够飞到美国来，现在也对 COVID 很紧张，因此我们没有团聚，我们什么也没有，我们四个人说是团聚了，好了，也没有了，因为我们一直都住在家里头。我的大女儿她是现在是大三，她整个这个从三月到回到北家来就没有离开，完全是网上上学，对不对？因此，那通常我们就是如果没有跟家人团聚的话，我们会请客人，我们会有留学生或者是其他的研究生，他们没有回家的可以来我们家。今年我们谁也不请 ，OK， 我们就四个留在家里头。因此，今年的感恩节就是吃点东西、聊聊天，就是四个人全家，跟其他每一天周末没有什么太大的不同。我不知道你们的那个的感恩节计划是什么样的计划。那 OK， 没有全家团聚，没有这种大庆祝，没有这种家人的这个亲密的这个经验，那至少我们可以感恩吧，对不对？我们可以说，哎呀，神啊，你这2020年怎么祝福了？我们可以感谢神。说实在，我不知道你在想什么。2020年今年到底有没有这个感恩的心，我不知道。我不知道你们有没有家人或者是亲戚他们病倒了，或者是我们对这个 COVID-19 有极大的忧虑或紧张，或者是说嘿，你的事业你的工作受到很大的打击。2020年真正想要感恩可能都不容易说得出来，好像最好是2020年赶快走啊，2021年赶快来，我们可以把今年忘掉，那我们说 Thanksgiving 这个感恩节就把它 cancel 掉好不好？我们就把它取消了，就今年不过感恩节好不好？我不知道你有没有这个想法。说实在了，我们大家可能今年这2020年实在是不简单。那我们会有这种概念说，那如果心里没有这个感恩的心，勉强去感恩也不太对，不太是真诚，没有这个真诚的心，对不对？因此这个地方我想跟大家谈一个很重要的圣经的原则。圣经里头不是说啊，我一定要有感恩的心才能感谢感恩。Okay? 我们想说是心里有，因此行出来。圣经不一样。圣经说行动出来，心里有。这个颠倒性，这个很重要的。我们来看一些圣经好不好？你要先请翻到帖撒罗尼迦前书，你有圣经？帖撒罗尼迦前书，我们来看，第五章，我们看第十六节，来读到十六节到十八节，来听好。
要常常喜乐，不住祷告，凡事谢恩，这就是神在耶稣基督里给你们的旨意。
那我们刚刚念的这段经文，它是从保罗所写的信，写给帖撒罗尼迦教会的信。啊，这个教会保罗啊，是保罗建立的。保罗原来他和提摩太他们跑到帖撒罗尼迦传耶稣的福音，那时候呢，很多人就变成信徒，因此教会就开始建立，因此保罗就建立一个教会。几年后，保罗差派提摩太回去帖撒罗尼迦，为什么呢？因为他听到那不好的消息，他们那个教会在帖撒罗尼迦那面对极大的压迫。极大的困难，他们好像很多人说有消息说他们这些人失去他们信心，要不当基督徒了。因此，保罗把提摩太拆去，提摩太回到保罗，告诉他说：“嘿，他们是面对极大的压迫、极大的困难、极大的挣扎，可是他们保持他们的信心。”保罗很高兴，保罗说：“哎，太好，太好了！”然后就写了这封信，叫帖撒罗尼迦前书。这一段在这个书呢，在他这个书的结尾，这个就是这封信，他结尾的时候怎么说的呢？常常喜乐，不住祷告，凡事谢恩，这就是神在基督耶稣里给你们的旨意。那你要记住哈，这段经文写给谁的？给这些教会，这个教会是在面对极大的压迫、极大的挣扎、极大的困苦，他叫他怎么样呢？让他们喜乐，让他们祷告，让他们谢恩。啊，你想想看啊，这份经文说出来好像是不是有点问题啊？是不是说嘿，如果你说嘿，你刚刚你的工作，你刚刚被你刚丢掉，你没有工作了，我告诉你嘿，喜乐啊，要尽量祷告啊，对不对？要谢恩啊，你会觉得说这个神经病啊， 你对保罗这样的话语，在尤其在困苦的时候，好像听起来是不是不是很舒服？对不对？在各种情况下，凡事情况下要谢恩。好，这句话是不是有点问题？这句话对他们有很极大的挑战，对我们也是很大的挑战。可是如果我们开始看圣经，仔细的研朝圣经的时候，我们开始看到在圣经里头呢，感恩、谢恩和喜乐是连在一起的。神创造我们是让我们能够，我们好像是里头就有这种倾向，是谢恩 和喜乐是连在一起的。我们诗篇可以看到，看诗篇第95篇。
来吧，我们来向耶和华歌唱，向拯救我们的磐石欢呼。我们来到他面前称谢他，用诗歌向他欢呼。全地应当向耶和华欢呼，应当欢欢喜喜侍奉耶和华，欢唱着到他的面前，应当充满感恩进入他的殿门，满口赞美进入他的院子，要感谢他，称颂他的名。愿人因耶和华的慈爱，因他向世人所行的启示称谢他。愿他们以感谢为祭献给他，欢欣地述说他的作为。
你看到没有？这三段经文，从这诗篇95、诗篇100、诗篇107，这三段经文里头都怎么说的呢？都说要感谢神，然后呢，喜乐，喜乐和感恩是连在一起的，很清楚的。那这个感恩，这个不只是说哦一个感恩的心，而是一种什么？有一个对象，我们感谢谁？是谁呢？我们感谢神，神赐给我们，我们是基督徒，我们相信神是赐给我们一切的。因此，感谢这个心是注重到，嘿，神给我们的，我们不配得。不是说我们应该有的，不是说哦，我们应该得到。如果我们说，嘿，我们老板给我们薪水哈，我们没有说哦，谢，不是我们替他工作，他给我们薪水是我们应该得到的。可是我们这个身体，我们的恩赐，我们的能力，神给我们的健康，神给我们的一切，这个世界一切都是属于神，那是神的恩典，他的心要赐给人这一切。因此，我们应该向他感谢。我们应该向他感谢。雅各书第一章17节这样说：
各样美好的赏赐，各样完备的恩赐，都是从上面，从众光之父降下来的。
一切是善的，一切是好的，一切是蛮完美的，都从我们天父而来。那我们得到一个礼物的时候，我们感谢，我们有谢恩的心。因此这三段经，这些经文都谈到说我们要对神要感谢，我们向神要感谢。因此感谢是这个方向。可是你有没有注意到那三段经诗篇的经文也谈到喜乐？喜乐，那我们喜欢感受喜乐，对不对？我们说啊，如果有喜乐，现在有喜乐多么好。可是我想2020年谈喜乐有点困难啊！我想我们想要感受喜乐，说实在，神也是想要我们感受喜乐。可是问题是什么呢？我们不知道喜乐的来源。我们经常说啊，喜乐什么样呢？是如果有很多钱，或者是有很多财务，有个大房子，有个新车子，我们有或者是有好的事业，或者有成功，我们可以得到喜乐。你有没有注意到啊？这种喜乐是非常短的，暂时的，拿到一个新的东西，马上就过去了，对不对啊？买了一个新车啊，新车喜欢几个月就是习惯，没什么了不起。拿到任何的东西来，哦，就是有什么特别好的事业或者特别好的成功，呀，就过去了。你有没有注意到？你有没有看到？你有没有认识很多很有钱、很有势力的人？他们呢，很生气，很不满意，对世界不满，很脾气很大。你有没有见过这种？ 他们再成就高，再成功，还是不满意，没有满足。你有没有见过一些没有什么多，没有什么，没有钱的，没有事业者，可是他们呢，充满了喜乐？你有没有见过这种？这是因为有些人了解事业的成功，有财产，有钱，有房子，有车，这些财务这些东西呢，与喜乐不是连在一起的，反而感恩的心和喜乐是连在一起的，感恩的心是连在一起的。如果你找到一个人，他知道怎么样学习会有感恩的心，你会看到一个喜乐的人。如果你看到一个真正喜乐的人，你会碰到一个他知道怎么样感恩，因为感恩喜乐是连在一起的，这是神在我们里头所创造的。那如果是这样子的话呢，那为什么感恩那么困难？感恩为什么困难？那说实在，感恩困难的原因很简单，因为我们通常觉得、啊、我们有的不够，我们想要更多，因此我们已经所有的，我们为他说感恩呢，我们会把这个心态把它推开了，因为我们想到什么呢？我们想要我们没有，我们想要的是我们没有的，对不对？那尤其说实在，生命是很困难。生命是很困难，像2020年大家都有点紧张，我们这政治季节，我不管 我想有些人现在这个投票结束以后，有很多人很不满意，对不对？如果你想要赢这个赢的没有赢，那你会很不满意，你会说啊，那你怎么会有喜乐的心，怎么会有感恩的心呢？你会说2020啊，很不高兴，对不对？那他有些人说不只是2020了，不只是有 COVID-19 或者是生命就是困难，生命是挣扎的。如果是有人是得癌症，有些是家里的那个爱人死了，有些人是我有这个这边痛，这个地方痛，我跟我的父母现在关系不好，我跟我的妻子，我的丈夫，我们的关系不好，我们有离婚了，我们有各种各样的情况。生命不容易，生命是困难，是困苦的。那我们说啊，怎么能够谢，怎么有感恩的心呢？生命那么苦，说感谢好像是假的嘛？有没有这种感觉说，说这是我在那边，这边说出来的跟心里感觉的完全不一样，对不对？我好像是在骗我自己一样，怎么办？问题在哪？问题是我们以为感恩是一种感受，这是一个问题。感恩不是一个感受，感恩是行动，这个是很重要的分别，很重要。我们以为说啊，我如果要里头有感恩的心态，才能够感谢，又变成行动。Okay, 我们以为我们需要有心理的感受才能开始行动出来，这不是圣经的教导。圣经的很重要是反过来的，反过来的，我们以为感经验造成行动，而完全是相反的，完全是相反的。感谢不是一种感受，而是行动，是什么？说神啊，谢谢你。我们开始这样说的时候呢，我们经常这样开始说的时候呢，我们感谢的心态就建造起来了。有这个感谢的心态，有这种感受，喜乐就来了，我们就经验到喜乐。那你注意到这些经文里头没有谈到什么、哦、你怎么样感谢神？感谢神、不复杂的，向神说，嘿，神啊，谢谢你，我谢谢你这个，谢谢你这个，谢谢你这个，因为我知道我这么一切不是我配的应该得到的，谢谢谢谢谢谢。这个行动如果我们一起这样做下去，其实是一个操练，这个是跟像打高尔夫球一样，你第一次打硬打得很烂，你多打，或是弹钢琴、弹吉他、慢跑，是一种操练。你运动的时候呢， 你的肌肉会强起来。你如果不动的时候呢，这肌肉会萎缩。感谢是一样的，是一个操练。我们向神说谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢的时候呢，我们这个感谢的这个肌肉就强起来，就在我们心里头建造一个经验到的一个感谢的心态，我们就经验到喜乐。这个很重要，因为喜乐的来源不是靠情况，不是靠啊，我们得到什么好东西，我跟你说啊，得到这个有喜乐，得到这个有喜乐，不是的，那些不是真的喜乐，那是暂时性的啊，是这样子。真正的喜乐是说啊，谢谢神，为什么？我一直在谢谢他，一直在谢谢他，一直在谢谢他，然后呢，在我心里头造成这个概念说啊，对哦，提醒我，我一切所有的不属于我的，不是我配得应该得到的，是神给我的，喜乐就来了。我们就经验喜乐，因为这个经验是神建造在我们里面，神设计人让我们如果能够感谢神，会在里头经验到感恩的心，然后经验到喜乐。我如果想要经验喜乐，我需要感谢行动。行动带我进入经验。我知道有些你们在听的，你们想说啊，这是基督徒这样子，就是不管怎么样伤痛，不管怎么出什么问题，只要笑就好了，对不对？就说心里在那个伤痛外面笑的全是假的，对不对？我们可以假装一切都很好，假装外面没事儿。这不是圣经所教的，你要搞清楚，这不是圣经所教的。我们刚刚看帖撒罗尼迦前书第五章，他说什么？他说他要喜乐，要感谢，还怎么样呢？还要祷告。你不只是感谢，不只是要有喜乐，还是怎么样呢？把我们经验我们的痛苦带给神，这是祈祷。我感谢不是说假装一切都是没事儿。OK， 我们基督徒不是作假的。不是说哦，把那个痛苦哦，不痛不痛不痛，不是这样子的，不是这样子的。我们感谢是因为我们知道神赐给了我们，可是我们不是为痛苦而感谢，或是说没有痛苦，不是这样子，那两个都不对。有痛苦就有痛苦，就应该向神说。祷告是跟神诚实的。你看圣经里头有诗篇是感恩的，有赞美的，也有怎么样呢？神啊，我在那边追求，我在那边哭泣，我在那边痛苦，我需要你帮助的，对不对？我这是有感恩，也有呼召呼求神的，两个都有，祷告和感谢两个行动都连在一起的。因此刚刚那段经文要看清楚，他说是凡事感谢，对不对？凡事感恩，他不是说为凡事感恩，不是说啊，我出了车祸，神啊，谢谢你让我出车祸，不是这样子的，不是这样子的，而是说出了车祸还是可以感谢神。在这个情况下，在不管什么情况下，我可以感谢神，因为神赐给我祝福，这是我知道，他给我一些我不配的，他给我永生，不是我配的。因此任何情况下我都会感谢神，可是不是为任何事情感谢神，不是说啊，我的好朋友去死掉了，神感谢神，不是这样子的，而什么样呢？呼求神，呼召神啊，我很痛苦啊。这个我们要了解啊，这个我们要小搞清楚，祈求神把我们的痛苦困难交给神，同样时间可以向他感谢，两个抓在一起。而今年2020年我们感恩节，我们可以把这两样事情都抓在一起，我们可以把2020所经验的苦水给神，也可以说嘿谢谢你，而且经常谢谢你。我这样说实在是纸上谈兵，不容易谈，不容易真正了解。今天我想给大家介绍一个我们教会的一位姐妹，她叫做 Sarah Stevens。他的生命，被他的感谢的这个操练，被他转变了。OK， 他开始学习这个感谢的操练。我们的牧师 Matt Metzger， 他今天他访问这位姐妹 Sarah Stevens， 我们来看。
Hey, Sarah. Hey, thanks so much for being willing to join us today. Hey, I know that for a lot of people here, there are people who know you, but a bunch don't know you. Can you just share a little bit about your story?
Yeah, sure. So I'm Sarah, of course, and I've been married to Craig for 31 years. We have 5 kids. We have Zach and Taylor and Luke and Noah by birth and Emily by marriage. And I am a Graham to Adeline Nicole and one on the way. We moved to Wanakee 15 years ago and have gone to Blackhawk for about the same amount of time. However, I grew up in Madison in a big Irish family that was awesome and big and loving, and that's also where my faith was founded. We, as a family, went to church most Sundays, and so I grew up with a belief in God, but I don't think it was until later in my life that I really understood what having a personal relationship with him was like.
Yeah. So, okay, I know that gratitude is a big part of your story. Can you tell us a little bit about how that came about?
Yeah, sure. So Craig and I were married in 1989, and we had Zach and Taylor pretty quickly after that and easily. And when we decided we wanted to have a third, it wasn't so easy. We struggled to get pregnant, and so, in fact, we needed doctors and medication to have that happen, but finally I did get pregnant, and Luke was born in 2001. And it was great, really great, but I didn't feel great. I felt off. There was just, I felt, I just wasn't myself. And so I just kind of called it a funk. Looking back, I think that that was probably a bit of postpartum depression.
Yeah, I know that that is a story for a lot of women in a church our size. I know I hear that story, I've heard it from women in the past, hear it today. So how did you handle that?
Probably not really well at first. I was just, it was in foreign territory. I didn't understand what was going on with me. But eventually I confided in a friend at church, and she was great and compassionate and kind, but she suggested that I go and buy a journal and write 3 things every night that I was grateful for. And I said no, because no. I was not a journaler. I had never written in a diary. And if I'm honest, I wasn't feeling really grateful at all. But after a bit of still feeling the same way, I thought, what can it hurt? So I just started. And it was hard. There were days where that page was empty and I wrote nothing. And then there were days where I wrote really, at the time, seemingly insignificant things like I got a shower, a 2-minute shower without a baby crying, or Zach and Taylor did not fight for 30 consecutive minutes in a day.
Big wins.
Huge at the time, huge. But as I did it, it became easier and easier. I found like myself during the day, something would happen and I think, oh, that's gonna be number 2. I can put that down. So I just felt my mindset was changing and I started to feel lighter and happier and more content. But I wanna be really clear and say this, that writing things down that you're grateful for is not a cure for postpartum depression. Yeah. I think I had a really mild case, and so this was one of the tools that I used with many other things and with help from doctors, and slowly but surely things did get better in that area.
Yeah, so okay, it had a really good result for you personally, but how, I'm interested to hear, how did it start to affect you and your relationship with God and your relationship with other people?
Yeah, so looking back, I think that time after Luke was born, and then I continued the practice of gratitude for many, many years. My relationship with God deepened. It felt so much more personal. And I think that's because I wasn't just writing down 3 things that I was grateful for. I also it was like a prayer of gratitude to God, because it was him who I was grateful to. I was not just grateful for things, but I was grateful to God for them. So my faith like grew exponentially during that, from that time till now.
That's good.
In terms of other people, I probably annoyed my family and friends because I talk about gratitude way too much. But back in 2008, I was in an online group with a group of like 20, 30 people around the country, and we had a shared experience. And it was a really good place. But after a bit, some negativity started creeping into the space. And I'm not a fan of negativity. It doesn't do anything for my soul. So I decided one day to just bring my practice of gratitude into that online group. And so I just posted, share a couple things you're grateful for. And it was a Tuesday, and I called it Grata Tuesday. It was really dorky, but it stuck. It did, it stuck. And we did that every week for many years. And then I took it to social media later on when social media became a bigger thing, personal social media and business. So now, like, my art community that I have, we do Grata Tuesday every week. I even, like, make some little fun templates for them to use to practice their journal, their gratitude, and share it and spread the attitude of gratitude.
All right, so Grata Tuesday's happening. Things are all seeming to go really well. You're practicing this. And then 2015 hits. Can you share a little bit with everybody about what took place then?
Yeah. So from 2013 to 2018, that five-year period, I had seven surgeries, which was not fun. The worst one was in 2015. They had discovered a tumor in my kidney, and they thought that it had a good chance of being cancer. So they removed part of my kidney and the tumor. Thank God the tumor was benign. So that was the great news. The downside of that was some damage was done during surgery to nerves in the kidney area, and I was left with chronic nerve pain. So I have experienced pain every single second of every single day.
So
since then, sorry.
Yeah. That's, so your story is not one of how grateful you are for miraculous healing that's taken place or anything like that.
No, it's not. I'm really grateful that it wasn't cancer.
Yeah.
But what it left me with was, you know, sometimes debilitating pain. And I have tried everything. I've seen all the doctors. I've taken all the medications that help with pain. In fact, the first one that I took, I was the one of the lucky 1-3% that has the side effect of depression. And so that medication sent me into my first, at 48 years old, into my first clinical major depression, and it was deep and dark and hard. But we tried other things. I've tried meditation and prayer, of course. Breathing techniques have been what really has worked for me. I even tried acupuncture. In fact, what was the last appointment, the acupuncturist was really kind and said, "Have you experienced any relief so far from your pain?" And I told her that I had not. And she said very honestly, "Then we don't think that you will, so you don't need to come anymore." And that was really hard. Acupuncture was my last hope. At least that's what it felt like at the time. And so I left that clinic, left her office, and I went out to my minivan. And I sat in the minivan and I cried and I screamed. I was so angry and bitter and mad at God. And I let him know.
Okay, I am just so glad, Sarah, that you're willing to go to a place of like rawness right now and say that out loud, because I think for a lot of people listening right now, there are those who feel like they couldn't be that way with God, especially if they're trying to move towards an idea of gratefulness and thankfulness. Mm-hmm. So where did you go from there?
Yeah. I ended up going back into habits that had been formed for many years. It wasn't easy, but I started to intentionally practice gratitude again. I had not been writing things down for a couple of years. I had had the attitude, and I looked for good things, but I hadn't written them down. So I went back to that, and it was like baby steps. It was not easy. There were days where I couldn't do it at all, and there were days that I was still yelling at God quite a bit. And now I don't write them down anymore. It's become almost like I'm hardwired to do it. I have practiced it for so long that it feels reflexive at this point. And yeah, so I just try really hard to focus on the good things every day, even when it's hard. You know, through chronic pain and other things from the other six surgeries, it's been hard, but yet I am still grateful.
Man, that's unbelievable. Okay, so here's what I'm guessing, is that there are some people who are hearing your story right now and saying, okay, Sarah, so great that you're there, but that's not me. I can't do that. That sounds too hard. If I were to try that, that would feel fake. Like, what would you say to that person?
I would say, I get it. I was you. I mean, that was me in 2001 when I said, no, I'm not gonna, that's a silly idea. Why would I wanna get a journal? I don't love journaling. I'm not grateful. I get it. But gosh, after practicing gratitude and seeing the benefits of it in my life, in good and bad times, for almost 20 years, I've learned a couple of lessons. The first one would be that, and people have heard me say this probably way too much, but gratitude is a muscle. And if you don't work it, it can't grow, it can't strengthen. So the more you move it and the more you exercise it, the stronger it gets. On the opposite end, if you don't use it, it can atrophy like a muscle in our body would as well. It can weaken. But the really cool thing is those times in my life when I kind of maybe stopped doing it for a bit and then something hard happened, it was like a muscle memory that had been built was there and it kicked right back in. It was like riding a bike for a kid. It doesn't mean that it was easy, but it was easier than if I had started. That would be the first lesson. The second would just be you're trying something new, and so it's going to take some time and practice. Practice makes progress, not perfect. And so just try things. Even when it's hard, even when you don't feel grateful, I actually think those are the most important days to be grateful, are on the ones that you're not feeling it at all. People think that you have to feel it to do it, but it's really honestly the opposite. You have to do it in order to feel it.
It's good. It's good. Well, Sarah, thank you so much for being willing to come in and just share your story and the way that God's worked in your life through this season. We really, really appreciate it.
Sarah 怎么说呢？她说我们以为是感到了才能做。她怎么说呢？她说你做了才能感受到。如果我们想要有这个感恩的心，我们需要感谢神，一个操练。这个操练让我得到真的喜乐，这是神在我们心里所见到的。我知道大家有些人你说，哎，我只要能够过一天一天这样过去就好了。这个季节里头，我们实在是很困难的情况下，我为什么需要感谢？因为感谢能让我活出一个喜乐的生命。我给你个挑战，好吧？这个给你一个挑战，很简单的挑战。找个笔记，找个笔记，打个笔。Okay? 每天写下三样事情，你可以感谢神的三样。如果你写不出三样事情，一个就好，一个就好，不需要大的，小小的都可以，没关系。OK， 今天到2020年的结尾有40天，我们今天开始好不好？今天笔记2020，今天是今天我们有40天写下来三样，如果三样找不到写一样，从这里开始我们来感谢神。40天的感激，这个操练给我们喜乐的心。 我邀请大家，我们一起来祷告。 天上的爸爸，你在我们心里所创造的是这种从感谢开始到我们感恩的心态，让我们得到喜乐。我们知道我们有的都是你逆而来的，我们不是配的，因为你不欠我们任何东西，可是你给我们生命，你给我们永生，你给我们的身体，你给我们恩赐，你给我们天才，你给我们各种各样的好处，不是我们配的，我们没有还给你任何，因此我们谢谢，这是应该的。可是你又让我们这样行动，活出我们应该的东西的时候呢，你又让我们得到喜乐，是太美好了，我们又在谢谢。虽然我们知道，你也知道我们心里，我们经常会忘掉，我们经常会看渴望别人有的而我没有的，我说啊他有我没有，因此我们失去我们感谢的心，我们不说谢谢。求你的圣灵在我们中间运行，转变我们的心，让我们有这个能力每天谢谢你，每天谢谢你。我们奉耶稣基督的求的，阿们。
的大能赐我生命，主耶稣，我夫妇敬拜你。宝贵是家的救恩，是你所立的约，你的爱永远不会改变。在接下来的祝福祷告之后，如果弟兄姐妹有祷告的需要，我会在以下的，在我的这个 notes 下面的这个、Zoom 的这个会议室有我个人的祷告室，那我一次可以给弟兄姐妹五分钟，那如果你先来你先进来，那如果你是、后来的就麻烦你耐心的等待一下，那五分钟我陪伴一位弟兄或姐妹祷告之后，然后我会再放第二位或者第三位这样子进来，那我应该会在这个祷告室里面20分钟到半个小时，有需要的弟兄姐妹欢迎、来、找我一起祷告。好，那我们今天就来做、一个祝福的祷告。愿我主耶稣基督的恩惠，天父上帝的慈爱，圣灵的感动与交通，与我们众人同在，从今时直到永永远远，阿们。感谢主，愿神祝福大家，我们下周见。